guys. I'm here with another Yinyasa class, which combines active Vinyasa and passive Yin poses. I'll kind of weave in and out of the two styles here and there. You'll see me use some props for comfort in some positions, especially for the Yin postures. You want to make sure that you have some support available so that you can relax and release a little bit more fully. If you don't have blocks, you can have pillows and blankets, anything you've got lying around that can help is perfect. We're going to start on hands and knees. I'm going to do a little cat-cow to get warmed up, get things moving. Inhale, tuck the toes, drop the belly, chest forward, cow. Exhale, flatten the feet, press down firmly, rounding up into cat. Moving back and forth with the breath. Inhale and exhale. Breathe slowly, deeply in and out through your nose. Notice how your back is feeling through this spinal extension and flexion. Might need a linger or an exercise side wiggle. Feel free to experiment. Let's do one more round. Okay, and let's just come back to neutral spine and table. We're going to do a little bit of warming up for the shoulders. I'm going to start with my left arm. I'm going to try to keep everything else pretty stable. I'm going to reach that arm forward. The palm is facing in toward the center of the mat. And I'm going to reach it up in a circle. Palm faces out. Reach it back toward that back leg. And then go back in the direction from which I came. And then I'll take it down and I'll do the other arm. Nice and slow. I'm going to do one more on each side. Harder than it looks. Okay, I'm going to stick with the shoulders. I'm going to take my left arm straight out to the side. And then I'm going to rotate back and forth a few times. And I'm trying to keep everything else pretty neutral and stable. And then next time my palm faces up, I've internally rotated from that shoulder. I'm going to bend that elbow and take the hand and rest it my lower back. And then I'm going to do some movement with the other side. Some scap push-ups here. So basically the shoulder blades drawing in and then pulling away, right? Retracting and protracting. One more. Okay, I'll reach that arm back out and down and take it to the other side. All right, arm reaches out wide and then rotate back and forth. And then palm faces up. I've internally rotated, bend the elbow, let the hand come to rest on the lower back. And then we'll do a few scap push-ups on that other side. One more. Okay, reach back out and down. And let's take a little rest in child's pose from here. And I'm going to let my elbows bend and let my arms get nice and soft and droopy because they are fatigued after that little bit of warming up.
One more breath here. Okay.
And then from here, I'm going to lift up just a little bit so that I can tuck my toes under. Right? And you might have to reach back and kind of get the pinky toes, the ones on that side of your foot to play along. And just give it a little push to feel some stretch at the base of the toes. Okay, and then from this position here, I'm gonna walk my hands forward a little bit more. All right, push into the hands, and I'm gonna hover the knees, and then lift up to a down dog, and then hover the knees back down, and then back and forth, right? Getting the legs a little warmer. One more. All right, and then we'll hang out in that down dog shape and maybe wiggle a little bit to get acclimated. See how things feel. Shake your head out, relax your neck. All right, let's walk the feet up near the hands and we'll just hang for a moment. In a nice easy fold, you can bend your knees, grab elbows, sway a little bit. Standing. All right, take a moment here and get settled into mountain pose. I like feet hip width, just feels really nice and solid and stable. You can adjust the width of your feet however you see fit to make sure it feels stable and strong. Stand up nice and tall. Inhale the arms overhead. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Plant the hands. Step back to plank. Inhale. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Breathe. Let's take it back up to the top of the mat. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, come all the way up, arms overhead. Exhale, let's take hands to hips. And you can absolutely do something different with your arms. You can keep them up if you like, prayer hands, what have you. We're just not gonna use our hands for the next little part. I'm gonna take the left knee up toward the chest and then step back to a lunge, ball the back foot. Take the knee down, back up, and then back to that knee lifted balance position. I'm gonna try that a few times. And then this time, I'm going to take that knee all the way down and stay there for a little bit and add a side stretch from here. Take the back of the right hand inside the right leg, reach the left arm up, and you'll see a little bend to the right, sliding that hand down inside the leg more, leaning to the right, feeling some nice stretch on the left side of the belly and the front side of that hip. to the mat and step into plank. Inhale. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Nice deep breaths. All right, let's take it back up to the top of the mat. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, come all the way up, arms overhead. Exhale, hands to hips or something else if you prefer. Again, we're gonna move back and forth from that balance pose to the lunges. So we'll take the right knee up. We'll step back. Take it down low. Take it back up. Lather, rinse, repeat. Last one. We'll end in our low lunge. Have a little rest and a little stretch here. Back of the left hand inside that left leg. Right arm reaches up. Hand slides down as we do a side bend to the left. Yummy goodness. Come on up. Both hands to the mat. Step into plank. Inhale. Exhale, lower all the way down to your belly. If you're chaturanga down, roll the shoulders back, release the feet. Inhale, baby cobra. Exhale, lower down. Let's do a few of those. This time, let's lift up and hold, and then keep pressing into the hands, straighten the arms, hover the legs, pulling through to up dog. Exhale, down dog. Take it back up to the top of the mat. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. All right, we're gonna come back to flat back, but think halfway up. It may be the same as your normal flat back, just kind of depending on your school of thought for how you do that and, you know, your flexibility, etc. But let's try to be about halfway up from here. I'm definitely gonna employ blocks for some of these next poses. Gonna lift the left leg straight up, hands in prayer, warrior three. Flex the foot, angle the big toe straight down, best you can feel. I'm gonna take a shorter step back, pyramid legs, but I'm gonna stay about halfway lifted or so. And then I'm gonna turn and twist to the right with arms wide, left fingertips lightly touching down, revolve triangle. I'm gonna come back to that halfway lift prayer hand position. And then I'm gonna open to the left. I'm gonna lift that left leg right into my block for half moon. I'm gonna come back to those pyramid legs, halfway lift position, hands in prayer, and then fold. And you may have to adjust your feet a little bit right. So from here, I'm gonna try to keep the feet in about the same spot. I'm gonna take a little squat position here. I'm gonna take the left knee down and kind of lean forward until I'm feeling some stretch in the Achilles area, lower calf area on the front leg. here, I'm going to go into a variation on side plank on the left hand. I call it funky side plank. If you've done my classes before, you probably know what that means. But the left side is going to be like side plank. The right foot's going to be out in front on the right side of the mat. So I'm going to take the left foot and step it back. As I roll to the outer edge of that foot, I'm going to take the right foot about halfway down, toes to the right. Inhale, hips higher, arm over. Exhale, lower the hips, lower the arm, check that left shoulder. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more time. And then we'll carefully lower all the way down. From here, I'm gonna come down to my left elbow. I'm gonna bend the bottom leg and reach for the foot. And then I'm gonna extend the top leg. And this is cat pulling its tail, yin pose. We'll hang out there for a little bit. So this is basically the first option. If you wanted to sit here, you could. If you wanted to kind of scooch and lower down where you're more on your back, you could. You could also grab the other foot with the other hand, right? And then that top leg gets a little bit of love as well. And it's a little bit more relaxing to lie down. Hopefully feeling on that bottom leg some stretch through the front part of the thigh, the quads, and especially if you're grabbing hold of that top foot with that leg extended, you might feel some outer hip, IT band area stretching. Take a couple more deep breaths here. Okay. I'm going to release hold of my feet. And I'm going to work to get back stacked on my side. And then plant the left hand. And let's try going up into a full, quote unquote, regular side plank from there. Down the plank. Inhale. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. We'll step it back up to the top of the mat. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Alright, again, we're going to come back up to halfway lift, which again might be exactly the same as your quote unquote flat back. It might be a little bit higher, just depending. So just think about parallel to the mat, give or take. Let's try hands in prayer. Alright, try to keep a nice straight back, and we'll float the right leg up hip height. Warrior three. We'll land a shorter step, pyramid legs, all right, about halfway lifted again, still with prayer hands. And then we'll open to the left, right fingertips lightly tapping. Revolve triangle. Back to halfway lift, prayer hands. And then we'll open to the other side, half moon. I'm going to use that block. Reaching up and opening. All right, I'm going to try to close the hip. Land again in those pyramid legs. Halfway lift. And then fold and take a little rest.
Stretch from here, bending both knees, taking the back knee down and letting the weight be a little bit more forward, feeling it right in there.
And getting set up for funky side plank on the right side. Right foot steps back, outer edge of that foot, left foot halfway down, toes are out. Inhale, arm over, hips higher. Exhale, get lower. Inhale. Exhale. Couple more times. All right, we'll lower all the way down carefully. Come down to the elbow. I'm gonna bend the bottom leg, extend the top leg, and try to grab that bottom foot for cat pulling its tail. And you can just sort of lounge in that position. And if you decide you get kind of tired holding yourself up on your elbow, you can be a little more reclined, right? If you want to maybe grab that other foot as well, go for it. And breathe. Let's take a few more deep breaths here. Okay, let's let go of the feet. Moving slowly, coming back to a sideline position if you had come down. And let's try to take it up into a stacked side plank. From here, balance is a little tricky. Down plank, inhale. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Okay.
right foot up to the top of the mat, warrior one. Back foot at about a 45 degree angle. Come on up, right? Try to even out through the hips and the pelvis. Try to be a little bit more neutral. Arms reach up. And let's clasp the hands behind the back. Interlace the fingers. Inhale, pull down, lift the chest. Exhale, full humble warrior. Drop your head and breathe. Pull with the hands. Let's come back up. Warrior one. Let's try not to move the front leg. Lift the back heel. Spin that foot open. Bend that knee. Elbows down to cactus, goddess pose. Pivot back forward, warrior one. Gonna reach forward and take the left hand down, lift the left leg, twist to the right, revolved half moon. Landing again in warrior one. Hands to the mat, step into plank, inhale. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Left foot to the top of the mat, warrior one. Come on up. Right, just check in with the hips and the pelvis. Right, try to find a little bit more of a neutral place. Hands behind the back. Inhale, lift. Exhale, fold. Humble warrior. Pull with the hands. Let's come back up. Warrior one. Try not to move that front leg. Lift the back heel, spin open, goddess. Pivot back forward, warrior one. Reach forward, right hand comes down, right leg lifts, twist to the left, revolved half moon. And back to warrior one. Hands to the mat, take it into plank, inhale. Exhale, through chaturanga, all the way down. Elbows reach forward for sphinx. We'll chill out here yin style for a little while. I like a block under my forehead. You can prop your belly up, your abdomen somewhere, chest, right, whatever you feel the need for. You don't have to. If you prop yourself up, then your arms can work a little bit less, right, so keep that in mind. I'll chill out here for a few moments and breathe. Let's take a few more deep breaths here.
All right. Let's come on all the way down and just take a moment to wiggle the hips to soothe the lower back. Great. While we're on our bellies, we're going to stay here a little bit longer and do a shoulder stretch from here. And you can do it a little bit less intense way and a little bit more intense way, just depending on how you want to take that. So we're going to do thread the needle shoulder stretch. And this takes the twist out of the equation, really. We're not really, you know, turning anything else since we're lying down. So you can kind of reach both arms out. I'll take my right arm under first, right, scooching it out to the left, palm faces up. So that would be the gentler variation, right? And you can just sort of let your head go down, it can turn, right, whatever position you want to be in there. If you want to try the more intense variation, walk the left arm out to the right, and also that palm faces up. And the more you know, let your head rest in, that weights the stretch. So you can have a block out in front also to rest your head on, or you can hold it up. We won't be here a very long time. It's pretty intense, the double version. Left arm reaches to the right. Maybe you stick with just the one or try both. Take it up into downward facing dog. From there. Shoulders feeling nice and warm. Right. Let's take it back up to the top of the mat. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Bend the knees. Inhale up, chair pose. Going to keep our chair base for eagle, standing on the right foot, left leg on top, left arm under, and maybe that eagle arm position feels a little bit more accessible after the stretch we just did. Let's keep the eagle arms, unwrap and step back to a lunge, ball the back foot. Okay, let the tailbone go down a bit. And let's try lifting the arms and finding a little back bend here. Arch back a bit. Release the arm cross, still arching back a touch. And then instead of arching back, we'll arch to the side with the back heel down, left arm down, reverse warrior. Lift up, reach forward for extended side angle. Maybe the right forearm on the thigh, arm down inside, left arm reaching overhead. Straighten the right leg, left arm up, triangle. up to warrior two. And then we're going to shift to the back leg for Skandasana. So we'll straighten the right leg, bend the left knee, little side lunge type of pose. And then we're going to shift toward the back of the mat to a lunge, prayer hands, elbow outside. Untwisting, hands down, and we'll set up our yin pose swan from here, which is just like pigeon. Let's scoot those back toes back, make space for the hips to settle. So upright technically a swan, folded is sleeping swan. You can decide to maybe spend a little time in each place. You can prop things up under either hip. I usually like a little pillow for my forehead, right? So you can figure out what feels best for you. You can turn your head from side to side after a little bit of time, right? Make sure things feel comfy and restful and supported, and make sure you're breathing. Okay, let's just take a few more deep breaths here. All right. So from here, I'm just going to go right to downward facing dog. You are more than welcome to press up to plank, chaturanga, up dog, down dog. If you're feeling like that, go for it. Once you are in your down dog, you may need a moment, right, to just sort of wiggle things out. All right. Let's take it back up to the top of the mat. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, fold. Bend the knees, inhale up, chair pose. Keeping the chair base for eagle, stand on the left foot, right leg on top, right arm under. the arms, unwrap the legs, step back to a lunge, ball the back foot, right, lift up right, tailbone down, right, lift the arms and arch back. Keep the arch, release the arms up. All right, we'll take the back foot down, right arm down, reverse warrior. Up and forward, extended side angle. Up to warrior two. My hips popping like crazy. It's always that one side, right? All right, shifting over to the other side for Skandasana. Staying toward that leg and shifting forward. That's tricky. Lunge, twist. And untwisting, getting set up for swan, aka pigeon. Here, knee to the right. Scoot that left leg back. Again, maybe you hang out upright for a little bit. Maybe you fold, change it up as needed, prop it up as needed. We'll chill out here for a little bit. Make sure you're breathing. Make sure your body feels supported, right? If your muscles are tensing up because of the position, your nervous system is never gonna let go, right? So give yourself a chance to relax and release. Let's take a few more deep breaths here. Inhale with control, right leg up toward the ceiling. Exhale, let's bring knee to nose and shift the weight forward, way up on the left tippy toes. I'm going to send this bent knee over toward the left and let my weight kind of turn in that direction. And then I'm going to have a seat with my legs in that position. I'm going to make sure that my sitting bones are even. You could prop your hips up. We're going to do a little bit of time in a side stretch and a little bit of time in a fold, yin style. So make sure it feels comfortable. You can prop this leg up. You can bend this knee. You can put something underneath it. You can have something to rest your elbow on. So we're going to do a little side bend toward that back leg, the straight leg. You can reach over. It doesn't matter, right? Anything resembling the position where you feel some stretch down the side, your right side, is great, right? So let's take a moment here. Depending on how your head is placed, you may also feel some stretch on the side of your neck, which is good. Make sure it's not too much, right? Adjust accordingly if you need more support. Let's take a couple more deep breaths in the side bend. Okay. And then from here, I'm going to come up out of the side bend and then walk it into a fold. Just basically folding in between the legs, not toward either leg, but just a straight fold. Any props that you wanted to out in front of you to rest on. from here, fall in triangle, will be on the right hand, right? So it's near that bent knee. I'm going to extend that right leg forward and out to the left, lift the hips, take the left arm up. And then for sure, if you wanted to plank, chaturanga, all that stuff, you could, or just take your hand down and step into down dog. Once you are in your down dog, take a moment again just to, you know, wiggle a little bit. Notice how things are feeling from side to side. From down dog, we'll inhale, left leg up. Exhale, knee to nose and shift forward. We'll bring that knee to the right and then sit for our leg position here. All right, we'll start with the side bend. Maybe you put a block inside your leg. Don't necessarily have to. You can rest your head on your hand. Your elbow might be on your leg. Right, just depending on how things feel. We'll chill out here in the side stretch for a moment or so. Again, just kind of check in with how your neck feels, right? So I'm feeling some pretty nice stretching on that side of my neck. Make sure that you feel like it's not too much. Make sure you're breathing. Couple more breaths here in the side bend. Okay, and then we'll come up. Take a moment. And then we'll fold forward. Maybe rest your arms, your torso on a prop. And we'll spend a moment or so here. Few more deep breaths here. All right. Gonna walk it up from there.
inches up. And as we take the hand down, you can go right to down dog or plank, chaturanga, up dog, and then down dog. Again, once you're in your down dog, wiggle it out a little bit. From here, we're gonna take knees down to the mat and move into another shoulder stretch, but it'll feel different than that from what we did on our bellies, a different part of the shoulder, right? So from here, try to keep hips over knees, walk your hands forward, and they can go a little wider. You can adjust the width of your hands depending on how that feels. So we're moving into puppy pose from here, letting the chest sink toward the mat. And the lower it gets, the more you'll feel in the shoulders. And you can put your forehead down, you can have a block, right, if you need a little bit less, or some other prop. Chin can be down for more. Just make sure it feels reasonable and that you can still breathe, right? And that your shirt's pulled down. You can try different foot positions while you're holding here. Walk that back into child's pose and just let the arms be droopier, right? Because they need a little rest after that stretch. All right. From here, let's come up and we're going to come onto our backs from here. Wind things down a little bit. And do a little bit more active work and then end with another couple of yin poses. All right, so from here, we're gonna be lying down and kind of take the legs up toward the ceiling and squeeze them together like they're just one leg, point the toes. Make sure that you can keep your lower back rooted down. So some people like to do this with hands underneath the lower back or even resting your lower back on a block. Right, so what we're going to do is lower the legs down and then lift them back up. And you get to decide, you know, how that feels. If you need to make an adjustment for your lower back, feel free to do so. You could do something different with your arms. Do a couple more. From here, we're gonna take the legs overhead for snail, which is our next yin pose, which is like plow. So you definitely wanna be cautious with your neck and make sure you're not forcing anything there. You could experiment with using
some props to help hold you up. That block probably isn't going to do a whole lot. A bolster might be nice. You can use your hands on your back. This is not one that I tend to hold for very long, just because I'm trying to be cautious with my neck.
From here, we're going to open the knees wide with the soles of the feet together for recline butterfly. And there's lots of ways to change it up if you feel the need to. Maybe props under your legs. You could have a prop under your lower back, right, which gives a little bit more intensity to the inner thigh hip feeling here. If you want to make it a little bit more restful and multitask and have a little chest opening, you can recline more at an incline, right, with props kind of holding you up. Straight up is nice too. We'll take a moment or so here and get settled. Nice easy breath. Get stretched out for Shavasana. Release the legs down, letting the feet fall open. Palms turn up, close your eyes. Relax your jaw, your face. Let everything go. Let your breath return to a natural state. And let yourself rest.
Let's start to wiggle fingers and toes. Deepen the breath. Circle wrists and ankles. Reach your arms overhead. Give yourself a long stretch. Fingertips down through your toes. Give your knees a hug in towards your chest. Rock from side to side. And roll over to your side and rest there. Very gently press up to seated. Close your eyes and bring your